There were more than 30,000 accidents on Jefferson County roads last year. That's 83 every day. But a WLKY investigation has revealed some roads are far more dangerous and deadly than others. WLKY Steve Tellier analyzed all of the accident data from last year. He joins us now with his surprising findings. Steve?
Vicki, the numbers reveal sort of a mixed picture that Louisville roadways are becoming less deadly but more accident prone, and one local road continues to be the worst offender.
It can happen in an instant.
Yesterday was a perfect day for us. It was just a happy day. And I can't believe he's gone.
His family had seen 25-year-old Chaz Edwards just a few hours before this happened. An early morning crash just last month at 28th and Broadway. Two people are injured. Edwards is killed.
It was surreal. And we're still kind of numb and trying to get our heads around, you know, everything that's going on.
He is another victim of a car accident, something that seems so ordinary but can be so very deadly. Last year, the number of people injured in crashes jumped 6%, but traffic deaths took a significant dive.
It's good news, certainly. Obviously, we love to hear when numbers like that go down.
The number of people killed on Louisville's roadways dropped 17% from 2010 to 2011, and there are other encouraging trends. The number of pedestrian deaths dropped significantly, and statistics indicate seatbelt use is up.
It doesn't take but a second to put it on and click it and make sure the people in your vehicle have a safety restraint on, especially children.
DUI-related fatalities, however, held steady. 15 people died in alcohol-related accidents, the same number as in the previous year.
Until you get the people to stop making that choice, you're going to continue to have those numbers.
But the most startling statistics are the number of accidents that occur on specific roadways. Greenbelt Highway, Fern Valley Road, Taylorsville Road, the Snyder, the Watterson, and I-65 had two fatal accidents each in 2011. 3rd Street Road and Preston Highway had three each. Poplar Level Road had four, but one road continues to be far and away the deadliest in Jefferson County.
Dixie, they always call Dixie Highway that way. So, unfortunately, as I've learned to adjust, it's the truth.
Dixie Highway had seven fatal accidents in 2011, one more than the previous year. To put that in perspective, all the interstates combined had eight.
It has a bad reputation for being a dangerous road. Why is that?
You put that many cars out there, the odds are you're going to have more collisions.
The so-called Dixie Dieway also had 280 injury accidents in 2011, significantly higher than the totals for the next most dangerous spots for drivers, the Watterson, I-65, Bardstown Road, and Broadway. But we wanted to take our analysis even further and find the most dangerous spot on the most dangerous road in Jefferson County, and we narrowed it down to a single mile.
This is dangerous to me, very much so.
And coming up tonight at 11, we'll tell you where that most dangerous mile is located, why it is so dangerous, and what's being done to make it safer. I'm Steve Tellier, WLKY News.